to you tonight, CDS. That's my message to you tonight, Antigua Barbuda. That's my message to you tonight, All Saints East and St. Louis. Rise up! Rise up! And let us get rid of the UPP. Rise up! Let us get rid of high income taxes. Rise up! Let us stop the pain! Let us stop the pain! Let us stop the pain! And vote labor again! Labor! Labor! Just and wrong! Let's suffer! Good night!
We must vote for labor again. So me and me neighbor, me and me neighbor, to stop the pain. We vote for Lester to stop the pain. Gaston and Samantha to stop the pain. We vote for Cutie to stop the pain. Green and
McGee. Young boy, you should be a parson. But you're still going to be a minister anyway. Good. Give it up for the man. Colored Senator Osborne Frederick of Atlanta. Now, boy, I always hear your cousin calling me. I always come for some class when I hear those people. And in the news, they say, you should tell me, Emma, who is attracting most of the class when I'm bringing you? Thank you very much. Lord, I'm a constant. Up next, folks, we're going to call on the man who says he got making cousin fart. Guess where he come from? You are not the man that is solid like fire and steel. The man who is going to represent you once more and give you proper representation. Antigua Barbuda, comrades and friends. Welcome on stage now, the Honorable Mullen Joseph! Chairman, political leader, Comrade Gaston Brown, other colleagues who are here tonight, let me tell you, it's an honor to be in City West to support a colleague, a man I've worked with, a man of proven competence, and someone that we must support to form the new government here in Antigua and Barbuda. When we meet in these large crowds, the opposition says that we can only attract large crowds when we have entertainment. But I don't see a beanie man here tonight. I don't see Peter Morgan. So I wonder why you all are here tonight in such large numbers. And I want to propose to you that there is something happening in Antigua and Barbuda that has never happened before. We have always spoken about the economic crisis in Antigua. We have always spoken about the social conditions that have gotten worse in Antigua. But this is the first election where the people of Antigua and Barbuda are looking in the future without a hope. And you're here tonight because this country is currently in a hopeless state. When we had the Hope concert, we had over 20,000 people. Tonight, in one constituency, we have over 3,000 people here tonight. And what the people of Antigua and Barbuda are feeling, they're feeling that something is wrong. Something is deep down wrong in this country. And I want to help you understand what is wrong in Antigua and Barbuda. We have always had a government under the Antigua Labour Party that has sought to unite Antigua and Barbuda. Unity in a country is important for the progress of the country. We cannot go through the future a divided nation. And we have a Prime Minister who has openly declared that he has divided this country in sheep and goats. Now if you have sheep, you have a shepherd. And this is the first shepherd that I see eat more than Irish sheep. Baldwin Spencer, the shepherd of the sheep, he eats more than his sheep. His sheep is starving. They are starving. While Baldwin Spencer is getting bigger and bigger. He even has the guts to call himself the big man. And indeed, he's a big man. But among the sheep, there are some sheep that eat like cows. They eat more grass than sheep. And let me tell you some of the grass they have eaten. When you look at the stadium that costs $10 million a mile, that is plenty grass for one sheep. Plenty grass, and that can't be a sheep. That is a camel disguised as a sheep. And that's what you have in Antigua and Barbuda. When he say that he is the shepherd of the sheep, keep in mind that there are some extraordinary sheep that Baldwin Spencer is leading. And those are the ones that are doing very well. And Baldwin Spencer projects himself as a man who has leadership qualities. Well, let me tell you this. Leadership is a measurable commodity. It's not what you talk, it's what you do. And when you measure leadership, I ask you only, those of you here tonight, to look at the record of Lester Bryan Byrd and look at his leadership and the development he has brought to this country. Look at the economic development. Look at the development in education. Look at the program we had for health care. Look at all the programs for young people. When we had the youth skills program that sought to get the young men off the streets of Antigua and Barbuda and give them a skill. But in 5 short years, the leader, Baldwin Spencer, called himself, must be measured by his record. And when you get ready to measure Baldwin Spencer's record, you must look at the issue of crime. You must look at the amount of killings in Antigua and Barbuda. And let me tell you this, we have a lot of scoundrels in this country that project themselves as loving Antigua and Barbuda. Just the other day, I think it was yesterday, when the captain of a yacht got shot in English Harbor, some of them disgracefully suggest that the Antigua Labour Party had something to do with that. And let me tell you something. They suggested the same thing when the 2 British citizens died. Now you tell me what kind of politics we have in Antigua and Barbuda that is seeking to exploit the people by suggesting a political organization to do such a thing. Antigua and Barbuda know, you know, that in 28 years we suppressed crime in this country. But you must remember that in May of 2005, Baldwin Spencer cut off the head of the police, and from since he did that, crime has increased without